Welcome to Elementary Python for CBSE. Today we are going to discuss a topic on basic computer organization. This is in the first unit of CBSE class 11 computer science, and we are going to have an overview of computer system. We'll see how a computer is organized, and we will see the different components of computer: the hardware, the software, and different types of software like system software, application software, utility software, etc. A computer is, as the name suggests, it is a device which is used for computation. A computer is an electronic device which accepts data and instruction as input, processes the data as per the given instruction, and produces the result, which we call as output. It stores the data electronically in binary form, in the form of zeros and ones, in the form of a pattern of zeros and ones. It offers many characteristics, many benefits, like it has high processing speed, large storage capacity, it is very accurate. It is applied in many different fields. It helps to automate the task, reduces cost. However, it lacks intelligence. That means it cannot do the task by its own. It has to be programmed. It has to be instructed to automate tasks. Nowadays, we are having systems or computers that has artificial intelligence. The three major units of a computer are input unit, processing unit, and output unit, depending upon the major functions of the computer. The input unit accepts user data and instruction. Like we enter or accept data through the keyboard, mouse, etc. Data is processed through the processing unit, which consists of three different units: the memory unit for storage of data, temporary storage of data during processing; the control unit, which controls and coordinates functioning of the different units; the arithmetic and logic unit, which processes the data and the instruction. It gets the data from the storage unit, returns the result to the storage unit. From the storage unit, the output unit produces the result through monitor, printer, etc. The two major components of a computer system is hardware and software. Whereas hardware are the physical parts that comprise a computer, software is a set of instructions that is given to do some task. Softwares cannot execute without hardware, and similarly, hardware cannot perform any work without software. Software we cannot see or touch, hardware we can see and touch, they are tangible, whereas software is intangible. Software we say it is developed, whereas hardware that is manufactured. When there is some problem in hardware, it is said to be repaired, whereas for some error, we debug the software. Some examples of software are operating system, web browser, MS Office, etc. Some examples of hardware are the CPU, the monitor, keyboard, mouse, speaker, etc. Memory, it is one of the important unit of a computer. It is used for storing and accessing data. Basically, memory can be divided into two categories: primary memory and secondary memory. Primary memory is used for temporary storage of data during processing, whereas secondary memory is used for permanent storage of data for future use in some secondary storage device like hard disk. Main memory or the primary memory has limited storage capacity, however it is faster, but the secondary memory is having high storage capacity, however it is slower, because the access time in secondary memory is equal to the seek time plus latency time, that is the time required to locate the data in the corresponding track and then in the sector. We'll see how a hard disk is organized. Different types of primary memory are RAM and ROM. Different types of secondary memory are hard disk, CD, DVD, pen drive, etc. The different units of memory. Memory is organized into different cells, or a number of cells or partitions we can say, which are capable of storing some fixed amount of data, which is called a word. Amount of byte in a word that is called word length, and typically it is 8 bytes. A word consists of some bytes, and half a byte is called a nibble. Each byte consists of a combination of the binary digits called bits, 0 and 1. So the smallest unit of memory is a bit, that is a 0 or a 1, and a group of such 8 bits is called a byte. 1024 bytes is called a kilobyte. 1024 kilobytes is called a megabyte. 1024 megabytes is called a gigabyte, and so on. We are having higher memory units such as terabyte, petabyte, etc. Primary memory is the main memory which is used for temporary storage of data. It can be divided broadly into two categories, random access memory and read-only memory. Random access memory is the main memory which is used for storing data during processing. However, read-only memory is a memory which is having pre-written programs known as microprograms that are provided by the manufacturer. Basically, ROM is used for reading of data, that is using or executing or running the microprograms, whereas random access memory is meant for both reading as well as writing of data, as we use them during processing. Random access memory is volatile, or RAM is volatile, that means when power is lost, then the data is also lost, whereas read-only memory is non-volatile, that means data is not lost even if power is lost, it is retained there in the ROM chip. Random access memory, it can be divided into static RAM or dynamic RAM. Different variations of ROM are programmable read-only memory, erasable programmable read-only memory, and EEPROM, etc. Random access memory, it can be divided into two types, static RAM and dynamic RAM. So static RAM means the data is retained till power is there. However, in dynamic RAM, the data gets lost over a time. As the voltage drains out, the data also fades away. So with dynamic RAM, refreshing is required, that means data has to be rewritten over the same place before it is lost. Dynamic RAM is cheaper and it is basically used as a main memory. Whereas static RAM, it does not require any refreshing because data is retained till power is there. But it is costlier as it is made up of semiconductor memory, and basically it is used as a case memory. Read-only memory, as we have already learned, that it stores the microprograms provided by the manufacturer, for example ROM, BIOS, the basic input output system, or booting up our system and initializing the various input output devices. ROM was basically designed only for using the microprograms. Change was not allowed. That is why it was termed as read-only. Improvements were made, and then it is allowed to add more programs to the ROM chip, and this is called programmable ROM. Another improvement was made where it is also allowed to add program as well as remove programs. Programs may be removed either by exposing to UV radiations, which is called UVPROM, or by electronically, which is called electronically erasable ROM. The accessing of data from main memory to the processor can be made faster by using a very high speed or extremely faster memory called as the case memory. It acts like a buffer between the RAM and the CPU. Case memory is basically used for frequently used data and instructions, so that they are immediately available to the CPU when required. Case memory, it helps in reducing the average access time to fetch data from the main memory. Case memory may be available in different levels like level 1, level 2, and so on. Case memory, it may be built into the processor or it may be placed outside the processor. Basically, case memory is made up of static memory or semiconductor memory. The data is retained till power is there. Registers are the smallest memory units we can see. After the data is accessed from the memory and it is available in the CPU, the CPU keeps the data for using or processing in different registers. So some commonly used registers are accumulator, memory address register, memory data register or memory buffer register, program counter, instruction register, some general purpose registers. So accumulator, it stores the most frequently data that is taken from the memory. The memory address register holds the address of the location to be accessed from memory. The memory data registers stores data part. The memory address register and memory data register together facilitate the communication of CPU and the main memory. That is, both memory address register and memory data register or buffer register together, they help in accessing data from the main memory. Then there may be a number of general purpose registers numbered as R0, R1, R2 and so on, which is used for storing temporary data during any ongoing operation. The program counter register keeps track of the execution of the program and it contains the memory address of the next instruction that has to be fetched. It also functions to count the number of instructions. The instruction register actually holds the instruction which is currently is being executed. If we look at the memory hierarchy, then we can say that the main memory has a larger storage capacity than the cache memory, and the secondary memory, it has a larger storage capacity than all the three. However, in terms of performance, registers are fastest. Cache memory is faster than main memory but slower as compared to register. Main memory is slower as compared to cache register but faster as compared to secondary memory, and secondary memory is the slowest one. The most commonly used secondary memory is the hard disk. Basically, secondary memory, it is used for storing data permanently in terms of files in the secondary storage device like hard disk. Data is stored in the form of magnetized particles. So if there is a presence of magnetized particle, then that is represented as 1 and absence represents 0. A hard disk, it consists of a disk platter, that means a number of disks mounted on a spindle that rotates at a very high speed. When we format a disk, then this divides the disk into tracks and sectors. Tracks are concentric circles and each track is divided into some fixed size sectors. So if we logically join the different tracks in all the disks that are available in a hard disk, then they provide the appearance of a cylinder. So we can also use the term cylinder in terms of tracks, because the number of tracks is equal to the number of cylinders, and we can say that each cylinder is then divided into some sectors. There is a read-write head assembly for reading or accessing of data, reading and writing of data or accessing of data. This read-write head may be fixed or it may be movable. If it is fixed, then for each track or cylinder there is a read-write head assembly, whereas if it is movable, then there is only one read-write head which moves in and out of the disks. The storage capacity of a hard disk can be determined by having the number of bytes per sector multiplied by the number of sectors multiplied by the number of cylinders multiplied by the number of surfaces. We must remember that the upper surface and the lower surface of the last disk, they are not used for storage of data. The most commonly used secondary storage device for providing multimedia data or storing multimedia data is the compact disks. There are many different variations of CDs or compact disks. They are the optical storage media, that means data is stored in the form of light property, that is using the laser technology. The compact disk, they are having very high data density, and the capacity of a commonly used CD is around 700 megabyte. The data is stored in the form of bits and holes, making patterns of zeros and ones, that is making patterns of binary data. Different variations of compact disc are CD-ROM, read-only memory, which is used by manufacturer to provide pre-stored multimedia data, CD-R or CD recordable, which allows to write the data only once and it cannot be erased, CD rewritable, which can be written, where data can be written multiple times, digital video disc, which are also known as super density discs, which can hold large amount of data. The storage capacity generally ranges from 4.7 GB to 17 GB. Also, these are available in different forms like DVD, recordable and rewritable. The red laser beam technology is used for storing and accessing data in case of CDs and DVDs. Another variation is a blue-ray disc, which uses a blue-violet laser that has a shorter wavelength than the red laser beam, and it allows to focus the laser with a greater precision, and hence it offers higher data density up to 128 GB. A newer memory technology is the flash memory, also known as USB key memory, which is a solid state memory like RAM. It offers very high storage capacity in a very small chip and basically used in cell phones, pen drives, etc. The working is similar to RAM, but the data is retained even when there is no power, just like static RAM. Let us now see some input-output devices. So, as we have already discussed that they are used for accepting data from the user, data instruction from the user. So, on accepting data, the input devices, they convert the human readable data into a computer readable form. Some commonly used input devices are keyboard, which is used for accepting character data, mouse, which is a pointing device or a cursor control device. There are different types of optical input devices like barcode reader, OMR, magnetic ink, character recognition, which are used for input of special map and character. Then there is scanner, which is used for input of image, digital or web camera, which is used for input of graphical and video data, microphone for input of audio data, joystick or trackball, generally used in gaming, software as a controlling device, then graphical pad for input of graphic data, a light pen, which is a pointing device with a photo cell similar to a pen. Let us now see some output devices. Output devices, they present system generated data in a human readable form. That means they help in converting the system generated data, which is in binary, into human readable form. So they provide the result through output devices like monitor, printer, plotter, speaker, etc. So monitor, it is also known as the visual display unit to display the output. Different types of monitors are cathode ray tube, which were used in earlier days, and nowadays many technologies are available like liquid crystal display, flat panel display, etc. Printers, they provide a printed or a hard copy of the output. Printers may be basically impact or non-impact printer. In case of impact printer, there is a striking effect. A print head is there which strike against the paper and the ribbon. Non-impact printer, they do not have any striking effect. So commonly used impact printers are dot matrix printer, daisy wheel printer, etc. Dot matrix printer was a very popular impact printer, which consisted of a grid of pins and patterns or characters are printed as a pattern of dots. Inkjet printer is a non-impact printer which uses a spraying of ink on the paper for printing of characters. Laser printer, they use laser technology to print the character. Plotters are graphical output devices. So different types of plotters are flatbed plotter, drum plotter, etc. Basically, they are used for printing large graphic output like flex, etc. speaker, it is used for audio or sound output. Now let us discuss different types of software. Basically, software can be divided into two categories: system software and application software. As the figure indicates here, system software, it is used for coordination with the hardware or functioning of the hardware, whereas application software, it is used by the user for performing different application or task. So system software controls the operation of the hardware or the computer. Application software, they perform the specific task of user. Some common tasks performed by system software are interpretation of command by given by the user, translation of human readable data into machine readable form, managing of resources, transmission of data between different devices, etc. Some common user applications are preparing documents, graphs, charts, etc. A system software provides an interface between the application software and the hardware. The application software needs the system software to run. It cannot run by its own, so it needs a system software upon which it will, as a platform upon which it will run. Some examples of system software are the different drivers, operating system, compilers, interpreters, etc. Some commonly used application software are web browser, media player, painting software, text editor, etc. Now let us see some utilities. Utilities are generally provided with the operating system and they are used for performing different housekeeping functions of the system, like the text editor for working with text files like Notepad, backup to have a copy of the data that may be useful in case the data is lost, compression for compressing large files so that they take less space and can be taken or communicated easily, disk defragmentation. This is used for speeding of disk access by rearranging the files and the free space so that the files, they occupy one contiguous block and the free space occupy another contiguous block. This helps in better utilization of the memory. Then disk cleanup. This is used for removing unnecessary files and free up the disk space. And the most commonly used utility software is the antivirus software, which is used for detecting the presence of viruses and removing them. Viruses are the malicious program which may affect the system performance. So antivirus software, they help in removing them and protecting the system. So that's all for this session. Thank you.